Good morning, students. Our today's lecture is on anatomy of coronary arteries. The learning objectives for this session are: at the end of session, students should be able to define coronary arteries. They should be able to describe nomenclature of coronary arteries. They should know characteristics of coronary arteries and how they differ from other arteries of our body. They must know branches of coronary arteries. We are also going to describe coronary dominance and its clinical importance. We are also going to discuss applied anatomy of coronary arteries at the end of this session. Coronary circulation refers to the vessels that supply and drain heart. Coronary arteries are named as such due to the way they encircle the heart. They form an arterial circle which surrounds the heart in coronary sulcus. Coronary sulcus is also called atrioventricular sulcus. The main trunks of right and left coronary artery occupy this sulcus except in the region of pulmonary funk. From this arterial circle, which is formed by right and left coronary arteries, an arterial loop in the anterior and inferior interventricular groove emerges. As shown in this diagram, there are two main coronary arteries, right and left. Right coronary artery arises from right aortic sinus, whereas the left coronary artery originates from left posterior aortic sinus. As shown in this diagram, this encircled area represents right aortic sinus, whereas the second encircled area represents left anterior aortic sinus. Aortic sinuses are dilatations above aortic valves. There are three dilatations. Two of them are coronary, that is, they give origin to the coronary arteries, and one of them is non-coronary. When the heart is relaxed, the backflow of the blood fills these valve pockets, therefore allowing the blood to enter the coronary arteries. Thus, coronaries are filled during diastole, in contrast to other arteries of the body, which are filled during systole. Why arteries of heart are named as coronary arteries? Coronary arteries are named as such due to the way they encircle the heart, much like a crown. They form an arterial circle which surrounds the heart in coronary sulcus or atrioventricular sulcus. The main trunks of right and left coronary artery occupy atrioventricular or coronary sulcus. From this arterial circle, an arterial loop runs in the anterior and inferior interventricular grooves. The anterior one is left anterior descending coronary artery and the posterior one is posterior interventricular artery, also called posterior descending coronary artery. Thus, the coronaries surround the heart like a crown surrounds the head. So is their nomenclature. What are the characteristics of coronary arteries? How do coronary arteries differ from other arteries of the body? Coronary arteries are basically vasa vasorum. Vasa vasorum are vessels which supply a blood vessel. They are the largest vasa vasorum of ascending aorta. All arteries of the body fill during systole, whereas the coronary arteries get filled during diastole. So the heart receives its blood supply during diastole when it is relaxed, not during systole, when musculature is contracted. Coronary arteries are classified functionally as end arteries, but anatomically anastomosed with each other at the arteriolar level. They are the only branches of ascending aorta. Density of capillaries of coronary artery is 80 times more than the skeletal muscle as it contracts continuously, that is at the rate of 70 beats per minute. Coronary arteries are more prone to atherosclerosis as compared to other arteries of our body. Now, what are anatomic end arteries? Anatomic end arteries are defined as vessels whose terminal branches do not anastomose with branches of arteries supplying adjacent areas. As shown in this diagram, two anatomic territories are supplied by two arteries. These arteries do not anastomose with each other, thus qualify as anatomic end arteries. Functional end arteries are vessels whose terminal branches do anastomose with those of the adjacent arteries. but the caliber of the anastomosis is insufficient to keep the tissues alive if one of the arteries becomes blocked. As shown in this diagram, two arteries, they anastomose with each other, but this anastomosis is not adequate enough to provide collateral circulation at the time of need. Thus, anatomic end arteries are true end arteries where there is no anastomosis, whereas in case of functional end arteries, anastomosis does exist between the adjacent vessels, but it is ineffectual anastomosis. An example of a true terminal arteries is that we supplies the retina. Retina is an example of a terminal end artery. An example of true terminal functional end artery supply segments of the brain. Coronaries are also example of functional end arteries. The difference between the functional and anatomic end arteries can be understood by this diagram. In the first section, area supplied by an end artery is blocked, undergoes ischemic necrosis. There is no collateral circulation between the two adjacent areas. In the second case, anastomosis does exist between the two vessels supplying adjacent area of a tissue. But in case of blockade, area supplied by blocked artery undergoes ischemic necrosis in spite of anastomosis with its surrounding vessel. What are major branches of coronary arteries? As already said, there are two coronary arteries, right and left. These arteries occupy atrioventricular groove except in the region of pulmonary trunk. The major branches of the two coronary arteries are right coronary artery arising from right aortic sinus. Then it gives a major branch near the right margin called right marginal branch. Then it enters the posterior part of the coronary sulcus and gives posterior descending coronary artery. The major branches of the left coronary artery are after it arises from left anterior aortic sinus. It gives a single trunk called the left coronary artery. This left coronary artery passes posterior to the pulmonary trunk, then divides into two major branches. One is called left anterior descending coronary artery, which descends in the anterior interventricular sulcus towards the apex of heart. The second major branch is called the circumflex branch of left coronary artery. At times, from left anterior descending coronary artery arises diagonal branch, and left circumflex artery gives left marginal branch of left coronary artery. Circumflex branch itself enters into the posterior part of the interventricular sulcus. In addition to above mentioned branch, in this diagram we can see SA nodal branch, which arises from the right coronary artery. Another branch, which is given to the infundibulum, is called the conus branch of the right coronary artery. Infundibulum also receives a conus branch from the left anterior descending coronary artery. Right coronary artery also gives branches to the right atrium. These branches are called atrial branches. It also gives branches to the right ventricle. These small branches are called the ventricular branches. Then it gives a large branch, as already said, which we called as the right marginal artery. After this, this enters into posterior part of atrioventricular sulcus, gives an AV nodal branch to the AV node. Thereafter, it anastomoses with the left circumflex branch of left coronary artery and gives posterior interventricular branch, which we also call posterior descending coronary artery in majority of the cases, accounting for right dominance. Left coronary artery, after arising from left aortic sinus, runs as a trunk, gives left anterior descending coronary artery and also left circumflex branch of left coronary artery. From the left descending coronary artery arises the diagonal branch, and from circumflex branch arises left marginal branch. In this simplified diagram, we can see the major and minor branches of two coronary arteries. As shown in this diagram, right coronary arises from right aortic sinus. One of its major branches is right marginal artery. Then it encircles and enters posterior part of the atrioventricular sulcus to continue as right coronary artery. At the beginning, it gives a branch to the SA node, which is called a nodal artery. This nodal artery is given in majority of the cases, occasionally this nodal artery can be branched from left coronary artery. Right coronary artery also gives a conus branch. This is also called the infundibular branch. It also gives atrial branches for the right atrium and few ventricular branches for the right ventricle from the posterior part of the right coronary artery in the atrioventricular sulcus arises AV nodal artery, which supplies AV node. It also gives their branches for the right atrium. Thus, both SA and AV node are supplied by branches of right coronary artery. From right coronary artery in the atrioventricular groove arises the dominant coronary artery. Dominant coronary artery is anatomically defined as the vessel which lies in the posterior interventricular sulcus. It is also called posterior descending coronary artery. Usually, it is a branch from right coronary artery. In 8% of the cases, dominant coronary arises from left coronary artery and we call it as left dominance. In 7% of the cases, dominant coronary artery arises both from right and left coronary arteries. That means we have two posterior descending coronary arteries in the posterior interventricular sulcus, and this condition is called codominance. From left anterior aortic sinus arises left coronary artery. This left coronary artery gives a large branch which is called left anterior descending coronary artery. This artery, as already said, lies in the anterior interventricular sulcus. This artery is more prone to atherosclerosis than any other artery of the heart. From left anterior descending coronary artery arises a conus branch or infundibular branch. Thus, infundibulum receives arterial supply both from right and left coronary arteries. As already said, left anterior descending coronary artery also gives a diagonal branch. Left marginal artery arises from the circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. Circumflex branch of the left coronary artery enters the posterior and part of atrioventricular sulcus where it gives ascending branches to the left atrium and descending branches to the left ventricle. In 8% of the cases, it gives posterior descending coronary artery accounting for left dominant. Circumflex branch of the left coronary artery then anastomosis in the posterior atrial ventricular sulcus with the right coronary artery. The arterial supply of heart. As already said, heart is supplied by two coronary arteries which originate from ascending aorta immediately above the aortic valve from the aortic sinuses. The coronary arteries and their branches run on the surface of heart being located inside the subendocardial fibrofatty, so cannot be easily seen on the surface. Coronary arteries are basically vasa vasorum of the ascending aorta. Anatomically speaking, coronary arteries are not end arteries, but functionally they behave like end arteries. As shown in this diagram, there are two major coronary arteries. Left coronary artery arising from left aortic sinus posterior to the pulmonary trunk, and right coronary artery arising from right anterior aortic sinus between the right atrium and pulmonary trunk. The left coronary artery. Left coronary artery arises from left posterior aortic sinus of ascending aorta immediately above the left aortic valve, as shown by this arrow. It is usually larger than the right coronary artery. It supplies major part of the heart, including greater part of the left atrium, left ventricle and interventricular septum. Anterior two-thirds of interventricular septum is supplied by left anterior descending coronary artery, whereas the posterior one-third is supplied by right coronary artery in case of right dominance. In case of left dominance, whole of the septum is supplied by left coronary artery. Left coronary artery also supplies left bundle branch. Rest of the conducting system of the heart, including SA node, AV node, are supplied by the right coronary artery. Branches of left coronary artery. As shown in this diagram, left coronary artery arises from left anterior aortic sinus posterior to the pulmonary trunk. Origin can be seen if we cut pulmonary trunk just above the pulmonic valves, as shown in this diagram. Thereafter, the vessel divides into two major arteries. One enters the anterior interventricular sulcus or groove and is called left anterior descending coronary artery. left anterior descending coronary artery gives a small branch called conus artery, which supplies the infundibulum. The second largest branch is left circumflex coronary artery. The left circumflex coronary artery, after entering the posterior part of the atrioventricular sulcus, gives branches which supply left atrium, as shown by this arrow. It also gives branches which supply the inferior wall of the left ventricle. These branches are called the ventricular branch. If we see the distribution of blood supply by the left coronary artery, it is left anterior descending coronary artery supplies the anterior wall of the right and left ventricle. It also gives septal branches which supply the anterior two-thirds of the interventricular septum. It also supplies the lateral wall of the left ventricle. In contrast, right coronary artery supplies anterior and inferior wall of the right ventricle. It also supplies posterior one-third of the interventricular septum in case of right dominance. Course of the left coronary artery. After arising from the ascending aorta, the left coronary artery runs forwards and to the left between the pulmonary trunk and left auricle. In this diagram, pulmonic trunk has been cut so that we can see the origin of the left coronary artery, posterior to the pulmonary trunk, then dividing into the left anterior descending and circumflex arteries. It then divides into an anterior interventricular and circumflex artery. The anterior interventricular artery runs downwards in the anterior interventricular groove to the apex of the heart. It then enters posteriorly around the apex of the heart to go into the posterior interventricular groove to terminate by anastomosing with the posterior interventricular artery, which is a branch of right coronary artery. As shown in this diagram, the circumflex artery winds around the left margin of the heart and continues in the left posterior coronary sulcus up to the posterior interventricular groove, where it ends by anastomosing with the right coronary artery. Branches and distribution of left coronary artery. Branches and distribution of left coronary artery. Anterior interventricular artery, which is also called left anterior descending coronary artery, supplies anterior part of interventricular septum. In fact, it supplies anterior two-thirds of interventricular septum. It also supplies greater part of left ventricle and part of right ventricle. Right bundle branch. The part of right bundle branch contained in the moderator band is supplied by left anterior descending coronary artery. Left anterior descending coronary artery also supplies anterior fasciculus of left bundle branch. It also supplies posterior division of left bundle branch of His, which is additionally supplied by branches from right coronary artery. Circumflex artery. It gives left marginal artery that supplies the left margin of left ventricle up to the apex of heart. Diagonal artery. It may originate directly from the trunk of the left coronary artery. Conus artery, given by left anterior descending coronary artery, supplies the pulmonary conus. In addition, there are atrial branches which supply the left atrium. So, areas of distribution of the left coronary artery are left atrium, left ventricle except the area adjoining the posterior interventricular groove, right ventricle adjacent to the anterior interventricular sulcus, anterior two-thirds of the interventricular septum. It supplies SA node in 35% of the cases. In 65% of individuals, SA node is supplied by right coronary artery. Very rarely, SA node may have dual blood supply, that is, it receives blood supply from both branches of right and circumflex branch of left coronary artery. Left coronary artery also supplies bundle of His. In addition to this, it supplies right bundle branch of His and anterior division of the left bundle branch. Posterior division of the left bundle branch receives its blood supply from terminal branches of left and right coronary artery. Right coronary artery arises from anterior aortic sinus of ascending aorta, as shown in this diagram. It passes to the right of the pulmonary trunk and runs along the coronary sulcus before branching near its origin. The right coronary artery usually gives off an ascending sinoatrial nodal branch, which supplies the SA node in most of the heart. The right marginal artery arises and moves along the right and inferior border of the heart towards the apex. Branches of right coronary artery. An early atrial branch passes in the groove between the right auricle and ascending aorta. It gives SA nodal branch in 65% of the individuals, which passes posteriorly around the superior vena cava to supply the SA node. As already said, in 35% of the cases, SA node is supplied by branches of left circumflex coronary artery. Rarely, SA node may have dual blood supply. Right marginal branch is given off as the right coronary artery approaches the inferior acute margin of the heart and continues along this border towards the apex of the heart. Right coronary artery also gives AV nodal branch in 90% of the individuals. In 10% of the individuals, AV node is supplied by left coronary artery. Atrioventricular node is supplied by right coronary artery in 90% of the cases. In 10% of the cases, it is supplied by left coronary artery. The largest branch of the right coronary artery is posterior interventricular branch, which enters into the posterior interventricular sulcus. Right coronary also supplies posterior division of the left bundle branch. The posterior interventricular branch, which lies in the posterior interventricular sulcus, is the largest branch of the right coronary artery. Posterior interventricular artery is usually a branch from the right coronary artery in 85% of the cases. In 8% of the cases, it is a branch from left coronary artery, and in 7% of the cases, branches from both right and left coronary artery are given, which occupy posterior interventricular sulcus, thus accounting for co-dominance. Branches of right coronary artery can be seen in this diagram. So this is SA nodal branch for SA node. This conus branch for infundibulum of the right ventricle. These small vessels are anterior ventricular branches for anterior surface of the right ventricle. Marginal branch, which moves towards the apex. Now, in the posterior aspect, we can see branches for the right atrium. Then there are posterior ventricular branches for the right ventricle. Posterior ventricular branches for inferior surface of the right ventricle. Then AV nodal branch, which supplies the atrioventricular node. And finally, posterior interventricular branch, which supplies the posterior one-third of interventricular septum and also adjacent parts of right and left ventricle. So in this slide, we will describe the distribution of the right coronary artery. The sinoatrial and atrioventricular nodes are supplied by the right coronary artery. The interatrial atrial septum is also supplied by the right coronary artery. A portion of the left atrium is supplied by the right coronary artery. Posterior inferior one-third of the interventricular septum in a portion of the posterior part of the left ventricle, the right atrium and the right ventricles. Now, what is coronary dominance? Coronary dominance is defined by the vessel which gives rise to the posterior descending artery, PDA, or posterior interventricular artery. PDA is also called posterior interventricular artery, which supplies the myocardium of the inferior third of the interventricular septum. Most of the hearts are right dominant. In 80% of the hearts, this vessel arises from the right coronary artery. In 8% of the cases, posterior interventricular artery arises from left circumflex artery. And in only 7% of the cases, posterior interventricular artery originates from right and circumflex artery. Thus, in co-dominance, there are two vessels in the posterior interventricular sulcus. These two vessels are given by the terminal branches of right and left coronary artery. Thus, posterior part of the septum is supplied here by branches from right and left coronary artery, as shown in the simplified diagram. In case of right dominance, posterior interventricular is branched from right coronary artery. In case of left dominance, posterior interventricular artery is a branch of left coronary artery, as shown in this simplified slide. In case of right dominant, posterior descending coronary artery is a branch of right coronary artery. In case of left dominant, it is branched from circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. In case of co-dominance, there are two vessels occupying the posterior interventricular sulcus, one originating from right coronary artery, and the second one originating from circumflex branch of left coronary artery. So what is the distribution of blood supply to the heart in case of right dominance, left dominance, and co-dominance? as shown in this diagram, in case of right dominant, posterior part of the interventricular sulcus, precisely speaking, posterior one-third of the interventricular sulcus is supplied by the branch from right coronary artery. In case of left dominant, whole of the interventricular septum is supplied by left coronary artery, anteriorly from branches of left anterior descending coronary artery and posteriorly by branches from circumflex branch of the left coronary artery. In case of codominant circulation, anterior two-third of the septum is supplied by left anterior descending branches, while as the posterior one-third of the septum receives blood supply from both branches of the right and left coronary artery. Now, before proceeding further, let us identify branches of coronary arteries. So, which branch is A? This is the acinodal branch. Which branch is B? B represents branches which are given by the right coronary artery to the right ventricle. C represents the marginal branches. D represents posterior interventricular branch or dominant coronary artery from right coronary artery. E represents left anterior descending coronary artery. F represents left marginal. It is also called the obtuse marginal branch. Heart is supplied by right and left coronary arteries during diastole. Right coronary artery originates from right anterior aortic sinus, whereas left coronary artery originates from left posterior aortic sinus. Coronary dominance is determined by the vessel which occupies posterior interventricular sulcus. Right dominance is seen in 85% of the cases, left dominance in 8%, and codominance in 7% of the cases. Commonest cause of coronary artery disease is atherosclerosis. It can be managed by stents or coronary bypass surgery. All veins of the heart drain via coronary sinus into right atrium except anterior cardiac veins and vena cordae minimi, which drain into all chambers of the heart.